Welcome to Control-M for SAP version 9 overview. In this video, you will learn about new features in Control-M for SAP version 9. First, Control-M for SAP now supports and is certified to work with SAP S/4HANA, the next generation SAP platform. We also added support for SAP Financial Closing Cockpit, or FCC, which helps to streamline month-end closing processes. These two additions are the latest in the list of Control-M supported SAP applications. SAP Financial Closing Cockpit, or FCC, reduces the time required for month-end closings, as we just mentioned, and also enables you to leverage Control-M application plugins and file transfers, expanding these month-end processes beyond SAP FCC. You can utilize all current R3 job capabilities for your FCC jobs, including monitoring, troubleshooting, and rerun from point of failure. In order to run a Control-M SAP FCC job, make sure that you have installed the SAP FCC add-on 2.0 on your SAP system. Next, let's take a closer look at some of the new features and actions in the job properties. For SAP jobs where you have parent-child relationships, you can now set the parent job to be dependent on the child jobs. For example, the status of the parent job will be ended OK only when all the child jobs have the ended OK status. You can also set the parent job to reflect the status of the child jobs. If any child jobs are running, the parent job will have a status of executing. In addition, for R3 jobs, in the monitoring domain, you can view the parent and child jobs in a tree view, which can be helpful when tracking or troubleshooting long-running jobs. You can now easily define an R3 job to watch for an SAP event, saving time for both administrators and users. In the SAP job properties, there are new actions that allow you to control the job runtime limit, similar to BIM job properties. You can set the job to have no time limit or run indefinitely, stop after a certain amount of time, for example, after 2 hours and 30 minutes, or stop at a specific time, for example, 5 o'clock. In addition, in the monitoring domain, you can view the link between the SAP job and the event that triggered it. You can also trigger an SAP event using a Control-M R3 job to start workflows on SAP. Previously, this required an OS job using a command line interface. Now you can select this action in the job properties. Also, from the Control-M R3 job properties, you can schedule the activation or deactivation of an SAP interception or event history profile instead of using the Control-M Configuration Manager. The last feature that we'll talk about is not new for SAP version 9, but some users may not be aware of it. You can define an SAP R3 job to run with a temporary variant. This saves time spent manually creating and deleting variants on SAP. In a Control-M job, you enter the values in the variant selection screen, and a temporary variant is created when the job begins executing on SAP. The variant is deleted after the job is removed from the SM37 screen on the SAP side. We hope this video will help you take advantage of these Control-M for SAP version 9 features and help you to incorporate them into your SAP workflows. For more information about these features, see the Control-M for SAP help. Thank you for watching this video.